recap what happened 2 weeks ago. If that's what y'all remember. So you all are walking through the woods. We'll pick up from there. And you all have time to discuss what you all plan to do. True, but you might want to have a plan before you get there. I mean, you have a gnome, and Bertorn's an elf. Who else is something off? And a gnome. I mean, you essentially are human. In the blood? You know how unsanitary that is? Fair argument. I mean, he's a muscle wizard, so. Just ask. What are you trying to ask here? You look at where the hobgoblin's ass coming there is, and he just holds up his fingers. Mean, does a hobgoblin have? I think they're five fingered. I think they hold up all 10 fingers. They will say enough to kill them. You get the impression they're not a fountain of information. He just kind of shrugs his shoulders. So the plan is now to send the cat. Alrighty. Will you all continue walking on? Anything else? I mean, y'all are free to discuss as you see fit. So you all continue walking through the forest. Eventually, you... Huh? Yeah, go ahead. What would you... You all continue on, and eventually you all start to see where it kind of clears out. And you can start to see buildings, decrepit, ancient buildings. The hobgoblin will look at Glaucus and say, "We are here." Well, well, as you all arrive at this area, you can see that it is a large kind of encamp. It's like a ancient, kind of almost forted in area. There are buildings on the outside. Sitting amongst them is a large fort. It is an incredible disheveled repair. Trees in the courtyard, things like that. You see several smaller buildings around the outside of the perimeter of the walls of that fort. Many of them, the roofs have collapsed in, walls have crumbled in, side lean-tos are falling down. Bricks have fallen out, things like that. It is several buildings, and they're all just in dilapidated states. You don't notice anybody, though. You all are probably 500 yards. Probably closer to 250 yards from the nearest building. It's in kind of a cleared-out area. There are trees grown up, though. Definitely tall trees, but it's not as thick as like the forest you've been walking through. You don't see any smoke from a campfire, no. You're in the middle of the day, so they're not gonna need like a fire to see either, so. You don't see one now. There are some spots where there are some towers that could potentially be used as watch spots. They are in very decrepit states, but you feel somebody was brave enough or willing enough they could go up there and watch from, yes. Okay, that's Josh's plan.
Sure.
I figure y'all could have a short rest on that. Alright, so you all stake it out. What are you looking for exactly? Like, what are you expecting to see? Where do you plan on setting up to watch? Just kind of like in the trees and just kind of watching on, or? I mean, there's several trees, yeah. I mean, it would take some rolls, but you could probably climb a tree. Give me an acrobatics roll. Why do you have advantage? I didn't say you get advantage. No. It hasn't. You get advantage when I say you get advantage, all right? I will give you the 18 though. It's good enough. You can climb the tree. Right, you can get a pine. You can kind of see. You can look around. You don't see any movement of any kind. No, you don't see any people of anything. You can kind of survey the area, and everything looks abandoned. Okay. So, while you're sitting up there, what is everybody else doing? While Salem is up in the tree, you notice a black bird fly out of one of the windows in the fort. You would need superior eyesight for that. You could see the bird. You saw it fly out. They did not. I mean, you know that pretty much, unless it's a massive piece of paper, you can pretty much roll it up and put it in a bird's leg, yeah. They get you over. If you use an African swallow, you're guaranteed next day delivery. And free shipping handling. Well, he would have to be in the courtyard. So he would have to get into the inside. Now he can. He can attempt to do that if he'd like. That's probably 400 or 500 yards away. The fort is from where you all are hiding. You can't really tell from where your vantage point. You can just kind of see it off, but you can't tell how tall it is compared to everything else. Yes. It's coming into early afternoon. Or probably closer to early evening. Okay. I mean, there's a fort surrounded by buildings. It ain't small. I said about 250 to the edge of the building. So I initially said 500, closer to 250, about 500 to the fort itself. So the first buildings are about 250 yards away. Slightly, but not. I mean, like, you're not gonna be hidden. I mean, you in theory could stealth up there, but it's entirely up to what you all think. If y'all would like to try it, you're free to try. So y'all are just going to wait around till nightfall? Okay. So you all set up camp. Okay. So you all set up camp. Nothing transpires. The hobgoblins have left. You continue. You see the raven, you see a blackbird again, your turn. You see nothing. Nothing has changed. And it has now become nightfall. Nah, go ahead. You're fine. You can just jump down, basically. You're not. Now that you've seen, though. Sure. Basically just kind of moving across the field. Sure. So you all stealthily work your way along, following Salem through the grass and amongst the trees and in areas towards the buildings. You have now made it to the first building. There are no windows. I mean, there are cutout holes, but there are no windows. Not for centuries. Not that you tell of, no. Okay, so you move up to the next building. You step up to the next building. Essentially, yes. I mean, they're different buildings, but they're all in. They're all in various levels of disrepair. They look like they've been sitting here for centuries. So the party moves up behind him, I suppose. So you're basically bounding Overwatch your way forward. So you'll have come up to the next building. Party regroups. Okay. So you move your way up to the next building. Yeah, basically. About 10. That wouldn't apply to your character. Would anybody even know this? Right, Jethro, give me a history check. You asked the question. You just know them to be ancient buildings, long before your time. Well, you've not seen buildings. You think they're from a long time. No, they're built with stone, so they're far too new for you. They are of stone construction. You think they'd be somewhat in several hundred years old. They look like they've been sitting here for several hundred years. You don't know. Your character has no idea that it's a building. Yep. Just dilapidated stone. I mean, you could make it so the group could see you. I mean, you can stick it there and wave at the group if you'd like. And make sure to be seen. Not so far, no. Was it 6-4? I'm confused. Okay. Okay. So you walk up quietly. You still don't hear anything. Okay. All of a sudden you hear something. You hear snap. As Jalu steps on a large rotted piece of wood and it breaks within his foot. Your foot is now stuck in a rotted log. Sure. Are you going to try and, like, pull it out, like, just forcefully, or are you trying to, like, just kind of wiggle it out? Well, your foot's stuck into the log. You stepped into the log, and the log just caved in around your foot. And now it's stuck. Okay. You're a couple buildings forward, yeah. Give me a strength check, then, as you try and break away the parts of the wood. Alright, so you break open enough so that you can get your foot out. Yeah, it's just like good trees falling over and just rotted there. Will you walk in? Oh, yeah, Bouch. Not a thing. Okay. You can hear the birds and the crickets, but you don't hear anything out of the ordinary. Well, it's surrounded by an entire wall. So you see the wall, you can kind of see the keep up above it. Like you can see like the dilapidated towers and stuff like that. Okay, so you walk up to the next house. Or you walk up to two houses, and the group follows behind you. So you're now two houses away from the walls. There's like this building, and there's another little building, and then there's a bit of a gap, about 75 to 100 feet. And then there's the wall, like the exterior wall around the kind of the fort, basically. It's not really a keep so much as it's like a fort. Okay. Ellie, you might know this, actually. Give me... You would. Give me a history check. Good enough. You know this to be a forward operational outpost. Basically, it's a small fort surrounded by basically support buildings that are kept outside the fort. It's basically just because they need to be inside the fort to make it the wall smaller. And basically, it's almost completely walled off. You can't see anything that identifies everything like that's gone. Because, you know, it would basically have tapestries. Like these, not tapestries, but giant, like, cloth banners or that. But they've all been they're either taken down or they've rotted away over the centuries that sit here. For the most part, it could be used as like a station or garrison, but it's much more temporary than that. In regards to, like, it wouldn't be, like, if it was a permanent location, there'd be much more buildings. There would actually be, the walls would be slightly bigger. It would be a slightly bigger area. You think it's more like a forward post. Like, an army would use this as kind of like a forward position. And then there would be, like, a bigger fort behind it that they would sit in behind. You aren't able. They weren't necessarily facing a specific direction. Like, there were three-dimensional defenses, so like it would go all the way around. So the defenses are on all the sides because you aren't certain. Based on the position, though, you do believe that it may have been from Greyhawk going outwardly, but it's hard to tell exactly. The walls are about 10 foot tall. They're fairly thick. You get the impression like basically that this is basically a kind of defensive location. Basically, the people around them would fall back into this fort and kind of defend out until help could arrive to relieve them, basically. It's not like a, just like a fort for the sake of just being there. It's actually, it's a defendable position. As far as, what do you mean? You would think there would be a gate here, but you don't see one. And the walls are kind of, like, the rock is kind of crumbled down a bit. So that there's not, like an opening, you're saying. There is a bit of moonlight. You have basically dim vision out about... I'm going to give you 60. I'm just going to give you the same as dark vision. 60 feet, you have dim vision. Not 60 feet. Beyond that, it's pretty black. Because there is some moonlight to see by. Although the trees do obscure some of it.
Hang on. Nimbus. Okay. Well, it just all got real quiet. That's how I went. Okay. Like, everybody just stopped talking. Okay, so you're going to just heave them up on top of the roof. Alrighty, so you hoist them up. You push them both up. Give me a strength check. Strength check. You're able to get him up there. All right, so you are both kind of climb on top of the roof. Or on top of the wall, sorry. You're now on the wall, as you can see, into the courtyard. Make a stealth check for me, both of you, please. Okay. As you walk up there, you see two gentlemen standing. And they appear to be talking to each other. But you hear no sound. You see one of them kind of glance over to where you all are at and then goes back to talking. Their lips are moving. You see them physically speaking, but you hear no noise.
I mean, you're on the other side of a wall. And you don't see any of this. I'm gonna go with... I mean, that's a fair argument. Let's go with no. You cannot. What do you do? Probably 25, 30 feet, give or take a little bit. They're down staying in the courtyard. They are standing near a door. You're still on the wall, as far as I know, unless you want to jump down. Broken off pieces of rock. It's all just, and it's just dilapidated rock. It's basically like it almost like a cobblestone pathway, basically. Yeah, they don't know what's going on. Like, it's you two up there. They see none of this. About 10 feet. Yeah, I mean, he leaned over and did it, yes. He made it obvious to you. I assume he did, anyway. Well, they're standing right... Like, the two guys are standing right beside a door. What? It's... No, it's not a door into the wall. Okay. No. No. You say this like you're scaling a 40-foot high. It's a 10-foot tall wall. Like, it won't take you 2 minutes at best. Yeah. Just a thought. I mean, Galactric can stand there and grab a hold of the wall, standing flat-footed, and put his hands on top of the wall. It's not a tall wall. It's 10 feet. You're gonna need a ladder too, right? And some climbing gear and a Sherpa. Wait. Yes, yards is a long explanation of distance. A yard is 3 feet. Or 100 of them is a football field. Technically, a football field is 120 yards because it's 10 yards each end for the end zone. But I know this because I've mowed and striped them before. If you would like to climb up Jalu, give me an acrobatics check as you basically pull your way up on top of the hill, on top of the wall. Alright, so you just kind of roll up onto the wall. Good deal. Are you sure? And if you fail, they're in armor. They're in chainmail, wielding weapons. About 30 feet. In theory, yes. Sure. In theory, you could do that. In theory, you could be a god. No, they're spiked helmets, so technically you take damage. And you need to find a mushroom. Maybe... I'm just trying to, like, I'm trying to picture this in my head. So you're going to jump down and, like, beside them and smack them with your stick. And, like, hit them with your stick as you come down. Okay. I tell you what. You all sit here and decide to devise your plan. I'm going to get a 5-minute bio break quick and get me another drink. And you all figure out your plan. That sound good? Okay. No, it sounds like the DM's just trying to make sure you all are on the same plan here. Before we start enacting a plan and then have people going, oh, that wasn't part of that. I didn't know he was on that plan. I'm back. What? You don't see any. They're just in chainmail and wielding pole arms. All
Alrighty. So what exactly is the plan here? Uh-huh. Okay. Okay. No, I'm not that. I'm just contemplating in my head exactly how this is gonna work. The DM's like, I didn't plan this part out. I thought there was a completely different plan going on about half an hour ago. Y'all spent a week planning this shit, and then... I didn't question y'all's plan one single time. Anyway, back to the matter at hand. Where? You'll see the two guards look over there. And you see one step forward. A minute. He kind of looks around. Kind of huffs his shoulders and turns back. He stepped forward about 5 feet. So he's about 25 feet away. It's whatever you would like to do. Alright, so as he steps forward, you're going to jump out and attack him. Okay. So when he turns his back to you, you jump out. Okay. Just 1 second. All right, so you leap forward. The other guard, you see, look up at you. Because he's looking in your exact direction. You see him start to point. But Salem, seeing as you jumped in attacking the other guy, I need you to make an attack, Make an attack roll. You do not hit. So you miss with your rapier and stick the rapier into the ground. It is at that moment that the guard that was looking at you steps forward and stabs at you with his polearm. Right, but he misses as you like fall to the ground. Okay. Are you jumping at something? Are you just like jumping down to the base of the wall? What's your plan now?
Yeah, basically. You're a monk, you get plus 10 feet jump range anyway. You have 60 foot jump range. You can make, or 40 foot jump range. You can make it. Yes, please. Alright, you hit him. Okay, he takes 10 points of bludgeon damage as you bash him in the back of the head. And he kind of stumbles forward and then turns. He is now presenting his front to you with his polearm. Chengus, what do you do? Yes. Actually, he's about 28 feet away, but we'll go 25. Because he didn't make it all the way back to the wall. He is now in front-on engaged with Jalu. Yeah, you could probably make that. I mean, it's 25 feet. You can jump that far. Oh, okay. You hit. Alrighty. So you crush him underneath the weight of your bone warhammer. Your spiked bone warhammer. And he goes to the ground dead. Let's see. Salem will be up next. So Salem, you've hit the ground. Your rapier is stuck in the mud. The guy has stabbed at you with his polearm, but has missed. What do you do? Sure. I mean, it's not hard. That hits. I think. Alright, so he takes 9 points of damage. So he takes 9 points of damage. He will then... Is that it? Okay. He will attack back. What's your AC is what? That he hits. And he hits you with a polearm, which is 1d12. Plus 4 for 5 points of damage. Fix that. Alrighty. And then he will sweeping strike across and hit Jalu. 12 does not hit. Alrighty. Jalu, you're up. No, there's not. I'm just going with it. Yes. Yes, it does. Chengus, you're up. Unless there's some Jalu can do. You hear nothing. You and Ellie have no idea that anything's happening. You hear nothing, you see nothing. It is complete silence.
Okay. Sure. Like, you can put her up on your shoulders and she can see over top, yeah. All right, Ellie. So you're boosted up. You can see over top. You see one of the guys, you see one guy laid in the ground, dead, from apparently a bone from being smashed. You see another one wielding a pole arm, has swung and hit Salem slightly, and has swung, and you didn't see the swing, but you see also squared off against Jalu. Chungus misses, so Chungus swings wildly and misses. Ellie, you say, give me a strength check just to pull yourself up there. Yeah. Your armor's kind of heavy. Alright, so you pull yourself up on top of the wall. Strength check to pull yourself up. Good enough. I didn't need any more. Is it DZ5 to strength to climb that wall? It's only 10 feet tall, guys. I kept telling you, it's a 10 foot tall wall. This thing is basically jumpable. By much. Fair argument. You hear nothing. You can see them, but you hear nothing. It should move to them at this point. Chungus missed, so it should be Salem. And he fails. Alright. And he will swing back. That doesn't hit. So, Jalu, you're up. That hits. 5 points of damage. He took 13. Okay. Alrighty, so he looks fairly hurt. Chungus, you're up. Oh, I'm sorry. Did you want to do something else? Oh, okay. Then go ahead. Do that. I was trying to help you. I shouldn't help you, the embarrassment. Yeah, I just knew it was going to happen. He smacks the mud. He gets mud in his eye. Ah, yeah. You cave in the breastplate. You see him spit blood and die. Good job, Chungus. You killed another man. Alright, Ellie. Glotar, you just saw Chungus kill the second man. What do you do now that you're on the wall? Okay. Not currently. Are you jumping straight to the bottom of the wall? Okay. I don't know if you're like jumping forward out into the midst of them, or you're just kind of like going to the other side of the wall. Wow. I mean, after all the shit they just did, you're just gonna like, I'm just gonna safely climb down this wall. It's only 1d6 damage. I mean, you're a healer. What's the scenario? You'll just heal your legs. Physician, heal thyself. How do you figure 8? Uh-huh. So he did. Assuming you meant those were adding. Or they were not, those fingers were not representative of a specific number. Damn, you broke my freaking mouse. Smart. Alright, so you drop down. Galactor, do you repeat? Do you follow? Or do you stay upper? Okay, so you drop down too. You are all now inside the courtyard. What do you do? Now, you see no hay bales or dumpsters. And no, you don't have any piano wire either. Okay.
emphasis on the word sneak.
So, about that. I would also like to point out the fact that they have no markings on them, and you all attack them without provocation. And they're incredibly intelligent creatures, too. I mean, you know, IQ buck 40 minimum. They killed two innocent men who had families. You don't know that? You don't know their backstory? They could be running an orphanage here. Two orphans got off the street, dedicated their lives to survive, to keeping orphans and those downtrodden, fed, and housed, escaped to the forest to get away from the city where they could actually afford to do it. Can't fault the logic. They could be running a meth lab out here. Or they could have been trying to cure cancer. Worked for Walter White. I mean, he didn't die of cancer. I mean, flawless logic. Sure, we'll just assume he's here. Yes. He is caught up and has now climbed and scaled the wall. As soon as Galactar gets back. I never heard that. I mean, my memory sucks and all, but... Alrighty. So you all now stand before the door in the courtyard. What do you do now? Chungus doesn't have a clue how the spell works. So you're going to try and stealth then. Is that the plan? Y'all are standing by the door. Yes, you all can hear each other speak. Correct. Yes. You can hear everything. You can hear the wildlife and stuff. So it would seem. Okay. I'll take care of it. I shall take care of it. Alrighty. So. We will go down a channel. Turn down the video game talk channel, Monk. Yeah, I couldn't drag you. Alrighty. So, you all stealth in the door. So, as you all come in, you walk down a set of stairs. You reach a T, beyond which you can see a small room, and to your left you can see into a large doorway. Which way do you go? Straight straight, like, you come down the stairs and you come to a T. So, straight, basically, it's straight ahead, actually. I'm sorry. It's not a T, but just straight ahead, you see a small room. To your left, you see a large door. Yes. Okay. You hear talking. No. Common. It's in common. No. You can't make out exactly. You can understand that it is common, though. There is a room straight ahead, yes. It is dark. Okay, so y'all are going back out. Okay. Okay. It was just a dark room. It was a dark room. Like, the room was just dark. There was no light. There's no light, yes. As far as I can tell, it's just dark. Like, the light of the room was just a dark room. Like, there was no, like, there was, like, a torch or a candle or anything like that in there. There's no window either. Because they would tell you they walked down a set of stairs. You could see them open the door and see a set of stairs laid down.
So your plan is to go forward. Okay. Hence the stairs down. One second. I figured it would. I know. You should now see terrain. You all can adjust your positioning as you see fit. This is the room you are. I'm Marxo. Nice to meet y'all. Monk has disconnected. It shows a fancy grass monk disconnected. And he's back. Yes. It just said connection lost. Waiting for connection. Monk, reconnection. It always does that from time to time. When did you cast Mage Armor the first time? Yeah, like y'all waited until nighttime. From, like, lunch. Okay. Yes, there is a door directly in front of you.
Stay a while and listen. That's quite a treasure you have there. I was actually watching that just the other day. It's okay. Do whatever you want to do. However you want to fling that door open. Yeah. You're there, Salem. Okay. 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 You push open the door. You can hear the conversation, and then it stops. By the way, you rolled a 2 on your stealth check. You see them, so you kind of push the door open slightly. The entire room goes silent. Are you going to push it open far enough to see? Well, a crack means you got just a little bit of the door open. Are you talking about you want to push it open far enough to see everything? Because what you're asking and what you're saying are two entirely different concepts in my head. Yeah. I mean, you can push it open enough to see the end of the room. Alright. You can see that guy standing there. He is squarely looking at you. He sees you. And you see him look over and go, "There's a rather big cat and a small man opening the door." So, the door flies open. Crikey! It's a beauty! What? Okay, then. You're gonna hang on. You're gonna hang on. Let me finish it. So you push the door open. You see 7 bandits all standing there.
No, there's not. They will look at you a little perplexed, and I'll start laughing hysterically. I need you all to roll initiative, please. No, but you did psychic damage to them. Negative 1 HP. Oh, God. They're juiced. They finally got that lethal date. No. There's three of us in this channel who understand it, but no. How many people have been watching? Two people in this channel don't understand what's going on. Moving on. Alrighty. Top of the turn. Bandit number three sees you. And as you fly up on the door, you see, he turns his hollers, and you see him reach down, and he pulls out a crossbow. A light crossbow. And he will fire it at Chungus. And hit. For 5 points of damage. You'll see him then throw down his crossbow, and he'll charge forward. Wielding a scimitar. 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. And it gets about there. Genghis, the man just shot you with a crossbow. Technically, I like crossbows, so it's not that pleased. Displeased. If you'd done that beforehand, you would have taken half damage. And you miss. you basically swing your bone hammer right past him, and the airbrush like just blows his hair back in like a shampoo commercial. Bandit 2 will charge at you with a scimitar. Also hit for a point of damage. Okay, Salem, you're up. Okay. Okay. No. That is a failure. All of my bandits immediately turn to Ellie and all open fire with explosive tipped
They throw alchemist fire into the hallway. It explodes with a 10d10 damage and a 20-foot blast radius. Oh, shit. Alright, so Bandit 1. He will pull out his crossbow and point it at Chungus. And miss. Ellie? By the way, Salem, the one in front of you is unconscious. It's safer outside. Okay. Okay. Alrighty. Well, pick a target, make an attack. That hits. Just crack him in the base of the skull and breaking his neck and back. Yeah, it's alright. No, he didn't. It was behind him. You dishonorable bastard. Just attack a man in his back. Alright. Bandit 4 will pull out his scimitar and charge. And we'll attack Salem. And miss. This bandit, seeing what just happened, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, we'll step up and go back to being hostile. And miss. Bartoran, you're up. Each block is 5 feet. 15, 20, 25, 30, 35. Sure. You would have advantage, so you would. I didn't need these bad guys. That hits.
So you run behind him and just, like, shank him in the ribs and kill him. Didn't need the bad guys at all. Jaloux. Yes. Do you need at least 45 to get there? Uh-huh. The start will crit and insta-kill him. It will hit. And it'll take 5 points of damage. Okay. All right. This one will step up, and we'll shoot Jalu. It misfires, and the bolt just kind of falls off the crossbow. Now, Galactor... You're up. Yes, that looks about right. Okay. And the bandit kind of takes it, but he shrugs off. He's just in shock. Bandit 6 is unconscious. Bandit 3. Mm-hmm. Bandit 3 will attack Chungus again. And hit. For 6 points of damage. Chungus, you're up. Okay, he's dead, but by 12, he had 2 left. Anything else, Chungus? You're gonna leave the unconscious man beside you, that was laying right beside you? Yeah, I know. Just saying. Just checking. Alright, he's unconscious. Salem, you're up. No. That is a no. Anything else? All right, you see Bandit 1 turn 10, 10, 20, 20, and start running. Ellie, you're up. Okay. That misses. He fails. He is wounded. Number four will attack Salem. And miss. This man's unconscious. Patoran, you're up. 5, 10, 50. Count the squares. 5, 10. All right, takes 8 points of damage. All right, Jelly, you're up. Sure. That hits. All right, he's hurt. Five, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50.
He'll step there, and you see this one run up and try and grab Batorin. I need you to make an opposed strength check for me, Batorin. Beat a 19. No. So all of a sudden you see Batorin get grabbed and wrestled to the ground. You're both now prone. You are now both prone and on the ground. He's got you tackled. He'll look at the other man and tell him to run. Galactar, you're up. I was just going to say fireball. That hits. Alright, you hit him and he bursts into flames. Alright, Bandit 6 is unconscious. Chungus, you're up. Okay. Okay. All right, he takes the damage. Okay, Bandit 2 is unconscious. Salem, you're up. No. Maybe? Yes. No, yes, maybe. I'm trying to think, what would give you the one? What's the one? Oh, you have Lucky Feet, don't you? He's a gnome. This is like, as like I'm trying to figure out, like, where was that reroll coming from? I'm like, okay, yes, no, maybe. Salem is the halfling, sorta. By the way, Salem, you're up. Or I just move on. Oh my God. Thanks for wasting our time. Moving on. I mean, for somebody who got one of my NPCs killed about 10 minutes ago, I don't want to hear dick, alright? That bandit could have been crucial to this fight. No. You get to reroll that one. So you get to crit and kill the guy in one hit. I'm not bitter. I'm not bitter at all. Moving on. Chungus gets smacked in the bed. Chungus is dying. Hit. Kills. Bandit 7. Okay. He fails mightily. He rolled a 1. Takes 4 points of damage. Okay. Let's see. Bandit 1's unconscious. So, Batorin, you're on the ground, wrestling around with this one guy. He's got you kind of in a full Nelson. So you give a strength check, and you beat his strength check. And his. You're able to get free. Just barely. No, that's just breaking free. You can still make an action. Okay. Yes. That hits. I just imagine you two kind of like laying there beside each other and you're just kind of slashing at this dude and killing him. And he's dead. Bandit 2 and Bandit are both dying, while Bandit 6 is stable. As far as you know, combat is over. What do you wish to do? Not currently, you don't. Yes. Two of them are. Right now. I'll show you the room. Nope. Same with this way over here. Yes. There are 3 doors. Somebody should have got up when they had the chance.
I like how you laid on the floor and fought him. Uh-huh. Well, we hadn't got to that point. There were doors. We discussed it. There were doors. That is a hallway. It leads like that. There's a door right there. You don't find any now. They have like 20 gold combined. Okay. Alrighty. You have a doorway to the left, you have a hallway to the north, you have three doors on the right hand side, and you have three bandits. What do you wish to do now? No. Wait, what? Wait. What? Okay, then. Aren't you all supposed to be good, party? Thank you, Chungus. I couldn't tell. Okay, you now have them sitting there. Wild magic surge. You cast fireball on yourself and incinerate everybody. Well, so about that Warhammer Warhammer fantasy game. Generally, yes. You could wake one of them up, sure. Yeah, a bit. He does. They're all awake.
They look at Walker and goes, Greyhawk has 17,000 people in it. The Blue River, there's 1,000 stones in the bridge, cobblestone. The tallest tree is made of elder wood. Like, what does everybody else do when he does this? Ellie, Jello. Wow. I don't have a king. Because we don't have a king. Don't play idiot, you moron. Oh, God. The king's outside. You get the impression he'll tell you whatever he wants, whatever you want to know to stay alive. Mike? I got free Wendy's? She's a stable lady over yonder in Greyhawk. Okay, then. Where is this going? Huh. Are you planning on torturing them? Are you planning on just interrogating them? Are you planning on killing them? So just asking questions. Washtery is life. Washtery is the bringer of balance. Washtery will bring about a change to this world. Washtery. Washtery speaks to all of us. He walks among us. I take orders from you. Washtery? You took it already. Don't know how many are here. They come and go. 25. We are stationed here. This is our home. You broke into our home and killed us. Washtery has told us to be here. Why else? Water flowed. What do you mean? A couple weeks, probably, at this point. Why are you asking me? I was never near no river. I was here. I've been here for months. Alright, give me an insight check. You don't sense any deception. You sense no deception. Godfrey? Who is Godfrey? Oh! You seem kind of think for a second. Mm-hmm. Oh, you mean Lord Thorns? Lord Thorns is an interesting man. Don't know why he's called Thorns, but whatever. He's a great warrior. One of Washtery's disciples, from my understanding. What of him? I suppose you've killed him as well. Did you walk him and slaughter? Did you walk him and stab him in the back as well? Bunch of cowards outraging an old man. He wasn't here. He goes, I have not seen Lord Thurns in a long time. I don't know what he was doing. Wait. We might be of use. Sure, make an insight check. He goes, I can tend horses. My companions can count. We know the password. Promise you let us go and we'll give you the password. Go farther down into the dungeon. Spare us and let us go, and we will give you the. We will just walk outside. They would. You get the impression he's trying to save his own ass at this point. He's being as truthful as he can be. The game goes, I am not a thief. I am a disciple. I am not a thug either. What makes you think I'm... I am not Bert. I am not Bert. Why do you must... Fine. I am Bert. Does that mean I get to live? Do you agree to my terms? That I will go out and be left alone? We will leave this building and you can do as you see fit. He looks confused. It's like, when was my second chance? When was my first one? You attacked us. You broke in here. He will look at you and go, fine. Untie me. Untie us. And we'll give you the password. You see him kind of twist his wrist and kind of move his arms and stuff like that. Okay. He's stable. He's fine. Okay. All right. He looks. Goes. Do you have a pen and paper, or a quill and parchment? I guess. Crickets? The blood of my enemies? You hand him the pen. He goes, the password is, in darkness, light is a falsehood. There is only shadows, and shadows upon those. You will understand the password. Yes. Sure. Yes, please. Yes, please. You get the impression he's being truthful. And you see the three of them turn and start walking towards the door.
Karen. Yep. And Brett did most of the talking. Y'all had the chance. Y'all named him. True. And that is where the session will end.